Hello students, from the last few classes we are discussing about exempted incomes under section 10. Under the same list, today we are going to discuss about one exemption, that is compensation received by the employee from his employer in the name of voluntary retirement benefit or voluntary retirement benefit under a voluntary retirement scheme. Either he may be a central government employee, state government employee, a private employee. Here we are having some provisions like he has to work under a particular employer or different kinds of employers up to a certain age limit. Either it may be 58 years or 60 years or 62 years, as the case may be. But sometimes some employees are not working up to his age of retirement. He may retire before the date of his retirement voluntarily, and that is called as voluntary retirement. Because of this event, the employer is giving some compensation, or employee is eligible to receive some compensation, that is called as voluntary retirement compensation. This is the income which is given by the employer to his employee. That's what it should be taxable in the heads, income from salary in the hands of the employee. At the time of calculation of salary in the hands of the employee, in the name of the salary, we have to concentrate whether the compensation is taxable or exempted. If it is taxable, how much is taxable? If it is exempted, how much is exempted? What is the provision? So, today we are going to discuss something about tax provision of any compensation received by the employee from his employer in the name of voluntary retirement scheme. Then what do you mean by voluntary retirement? If an employee accepts retirement willingly in lieu of compensation, then such retirement is known as voluntary retirement. That is nothing but voluntarily has to retire. There is no force. I am taking the decision, I have to retire. So it's my willingness. So there is no force. If there is a force of sending the employee to the outside, that is called as retrenchment. It is not voluntary retirement. So, in the previous class, we have discussed about retrenchment. Retrenchment is completely different. It is kicking out the employee. But here, voluntary retirement, that is voluntarily retiring from the service. Because up to that age, he can work. But now, he is not willing to work up to that age. That's what he is taking retirement before that. So, that is called as voluntary retirement. Then, I told in the beginning, voluntary retirement scheme. Because if he want to retire from the service, he should comes under a certain service scheme, that is called voluntary retirement scheme. Then what do you mean by voluntary retirement scheme? Before going to understanding the tax provision about compensation received by the employee in the name of voluntary retirement compensation, first we have to understand what do you mean by voluntary retirement scheme, that is popularly known as VRS. So many concepts are there. Today I will discuss about major points which is related to our topic, that is the compensation exemption. The first one is, usually this popular VRS scheme is not today's or yesterday's. It is introduced in the early 1980s, especially in central public sector undertakings in the 1980s. In the 1980s, public sector undertakings give the opportunity to the employee for going outside before retirement dates in the name of voluntary retirement. That is in the 1980s. It is a scheme whereby the employee is offered voluntary retire from his service before his retirement date. As we discussed earlier, there is a retirement date. So, before the retirement date, he is having the willingness, and there is an opportunity to the employee retire from your service before the service date, sorry, retirement date. Another condition is there shall be no recruitment against vacancies arising out of VRS. For example, there is a public sector undertaking. In that particular unit, there is a manager post. If a manager is retiring from that particular service in the name of VRS, there should not be a replacement of that manager. So, other condition, that is the provisions of scheme. Once he VRS, and the post will be remain vacant because he is not working more there. So, this is major points in connection with voluntary retirement scheme. The first one is, it is introduced in the year or the early of 1980s in the central public sector units. Second one is, So once he is going outside in the name of voluntary retirement, so he should retire before the date of his retirement. And third one is, there should not be replacement of his post at the time of his VRS. These are the major points in connection with the voluntary retirement scheme. Then as per section 10, subsection 10, so many exemptions are there. Here also the employee is receiving any compensation from the employer in the name of compensation of VRS, it is also exempted certain extent as per section 10, subsection 10C. Section 10, subsection 10C explains what you mean by exemption amount. So here we have to discuss about how much is exempted, how much is taxable, how much is included in the salary, how much should not include in the salary. Before going to calculate the amount of exemption, we have to concentrate on, to get the exemption, certain condition has to be satisfied. If an SSC or an employee wants to claim the exemption under section 10, subsection 10C, certain conditions has to be satisfied at the time of VRS. The most important condition is compensation received from specified employer. So there is a list of employers are there. Central government specified certain employers as specified employers. That is the first one. In the sense, he should working at specified employer. Second one, compensation received as VRS framed in accordance with prescribed guidelines. So as per Income Tax Act, we have to follow the provisions which is framed in India about VRS. That has to be satisfied. So what is the amount of VRS that should be given as per the provision? It should not be calculated individually. So as per the provision, first we have to calculate by VRS amount. So that should be included. So these two conditions has to be satisfied for the purpose of claiming the exemption under section 10, subsection 10C. So this is condition. Before that, we discussed what do you mean by retrenchment compensation. So next we are going to discuss about amount of exemption. As I said earlier, at the time of VRS, he is taking so many retirement benefits. Along with the retirement benefit, he is also receiving some compensation in the name of VRS. So some amount of VRS compensation given by the employer, out of that particular amount, how much is exempted, that we are going to calculate here. The excess amount is taxable anyhow, but how much is exempted, that we have to calculate it. For that purpose, we have to go understanding the exemption provision under section 10, subsection 10C. Like any other exemption, what we discussed here before, here also certain provisions are there. So, while according to the respective provisions, which is the least amount that has to be taken, that we will discuss in the next class. So, students, today we have discussed about what do you mean by VRS compensation. What is the meaning of VRS scheme provisions and what is the conditions to be satisfied by the employee or employer for the purpose of receiving the compensation or allowing the exemption under section 10, subsection 10C. Thank you.